this. I'm going to come around behind you, though, if I can.
I think Maya's needs fixed,
too. Wants to what?
Maya's needs fixed.
Okay, I'll look. Hers look okay.
Does it?
Yeah, hers. Yours is, the chin rubs are on the inside. You got to get them on the outside.
Ah, look at that.
That's so much better. Okay. Let me see what that's like. That's cool.
Thank you.
Maya's hers is right there. Maya, okay. You're good. Sit. She's sitting.
Yeah,
she wants to. There she is.
Test.
Yeah, that one looks about your size.
I'm reaching in front of you for a second.
So we don't pick my singing up?
That's fine. Or Kate's mic. Kate's mic.
Are you talking first?
No.
After the first song, she's going to do an intro to the crowd. Yes. Intro us to the crowd. Mm-hmm. I think we've done three at least right now. Yeah, you can say something about them, sing along.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us today. My name is Barry Nayback, and this is the band, the Irish Band. We're going to start this first song. The words to this song, Here's a Hell to the Company, are in the back of your program. If you could all join us, if you know this song, we've done it probably 3 years in a row now, so you should all know it. So we're going to do the chorus twice, and then we're going to do some verses. Just sing along if you know the tune. Thank you. So here's a health to the company, and one to my lass. Let's drink and be merry, all out of one glass. Let's drink and be merry, all grief to refrain. For we may or might never all meet here again. Kind friends and companions, come join me in rhyme. Come lift up your voices in chorus with mine. Come lift up your voices, all grief to remain. For we may or might never all meet here again. Here we go. So here's a health to the company, and one to my lass. Let's drink and be merry, all out of one glass. Let's drink and be merry, all grief to refrain. For we may or might never all meet here again. Take it away, Bob.
Here's a health to the wee lads that I love so well. For style and for beauty, sure none can excel. There's a smile on her countenance as she sits on my knee. There's no man in this wide world all happy as me.
So here's a health to the company, and one to my lass. Let's drink and be merry, all out of one glass. Let's drink and be merry, all grief to refrain. For we may or might never all meet here again.
We are gathered together to dance, play, and sing. Let us raise up our glasses to the music. We'll drink and be merry, and we'll always be friends, even if we might never all
here's a health to the company, and one to my lass. Let's drink and be merry, all out of one glass. Let's drink and be merry, all grief to refrain. For we may or might never all meet here again.
Great job, everyone.
Thank you. Welcome. Sherry's going to introduce.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to First Congregational Church. We're so glad you could be here for our annual St. Patrick's Day concert. My name is Sherry Lendo. I'm just a member of this wonderful church, and I've been asked to welcome you all here. If you haven't been to a concert here before, you are in for a great treat. And speaking of treats, we're going to have treats out in the narthex after the concert is over. We have cookies and punch and refreshments. So please join us for that after the concert and just enjoy. I want to thank all the musicians and especially Melissa for putting this together. So thank you.
I think one of the reasons we like Irish music so much is it can be an emotional roller coaster ride. Some songs are fun, some songs are sad, some songs are everything, and this one's called This Love Will Carry. It's an emotional roller coaster ride.
And this one is by contemporary Scottish musician Dougie MacLean. You've heard us play some of his music before if you were here last year. And so this year we're kind of going with a kind of contemporary theme, so some of what you hear are going to be from more modern artists like Dougie MacLean, and you'll see like even some Johnny Cash and everything further on.
It's a thin line that leads us, keeps us all from shame. Dark clouds quickly gather along the way we came. There's fear out on the mountain and slipped out on the plain. There's heartbreak and heartache in the shadow of the flame. this love will carry. This love will carry me. I know this love will carry me. This love will carry. This love will carry me. I know this love will carry me. The strongest web will tangle. The sweetest bloom will fail. Somewhere in the distance, we try to catch it all. Success lasts for a moment, and failure is always near. You look down at your blistered hands as turns another year. This love will carry. This love will carry me. I know this love will carry me. This love will carry. This love will carry me. I know this love will carry me. All right, Karen and Kate. These days are golden, they must not waste away. And somewhere flower, and soon it will decay. And though by storms we are weakened, and uncertainty is sure. Like the coming of the dawn, it's ours forevermore. This love will carry. This love will carry me. I know this love will carry me. This love will carry. This love will carry me. I know this love will carry me. I know this love will carry me.
Everyone, I think you have the words to this one, too. You can't shove your granny off a bus. It's a very fun song. We're going to do a little intro, and then we'll do the chorus twice.
This is for all the grannies that have not been shoved off the bus. Okay.
And also, we should note that some of you may have in mind someone who you would like to shove off the bus, and you don't have to say it out loud, and we're not going to judge.
Shove your granny off a bus.
Off the bus.
Oh, you can't shove your your granny off a bus. Oh, you can't shove your granny, cause she's your mammy's mammy. Oh, you can't shove your granny off a bus. Oh, you can't shove your granny off a bus. You can shove your other granny off a bus.
Off the bus.
You can shove your other granny, cause she's your father's mammy. Oh, you can shove your granny off a bus.
Off the bus.
Oh, you can shove your granny off a bus.
Off the bus.
Oh, you can shove your granny off a bus.
Off the bus.
Oh, you can shove your granny, cause she's a mammy's mammy. Oh, you can shove your granny off a bus.
You can shove your drunken uncle off the bus.
That'll be easy.
You can shove your drunken uncle off the bus.
You can go back and find him later.
You can shove your drunken uncle, for he needs another bottle. You can shove your drunken uncle off the bus.
Off the bus.
You can shove your drunken granny off the bus. Or you can shove your granny off the bus. Oh, you can shove your granny, cause she's your nanny's nanny. Oh, you can shove your granny off the bus. What?
You can shove your Auntie Maggie off the bus. You can shove your Auntie Maggie off the bus.
Off the bus.
Auntie Meg's your brother's sister, but she's nothing but a twister. You can shove your Auntie Maggie off the bus.
Off the bus. Oh, you can't shove your granny off the bus. Oh, you can't shove your granny off the bus. Oh, you can't shove your granny, cause she's your mammy's mammy. Oh, you can't shove your granny off a bus.
You can shove your baby brother off the bus.
Absolutely.
You can shove your baby brother off the bus.
Off the bus.
You can shove your baby brother. It's okay, cause there are five others. You can shove your baby brother off the bus.
Off the bus.
Or you can shove your granny off the bus.
Or you can shove your granny off the bus. Or you can shove your granny, cause she's your mammy's mammy. Or you can shove your granny off a bus. You can shove your ugly cousin off the bus.
Off the bus.
You can shove your ugly cousin off the bus.
Off the bus.
You can shove your ugly cousin, cause they're a dime a dozen.
Another one.
You can
will be along
shove your ugly cousin off the bus.
Off the bus.
Oh, you can shove your granny off the bus. Oh, you can shove your granny off the bus.
Off the bus.
Oh, you can shove your granny, cause she's your mammy. Oh, you can shove your granny off a bus.
You can shove your stupid sister-in-law off the bus.
Off the bus.
You can shove your stupid sister-in-law off the bus.
Off the bus.
She may be married to your brother, but you don't have to love her. You can shove your stupid sister-in-law off the bus.
Off the bus. Oh, you can shove your granny off the bus.
Off the bus.
Oh, you can shove your granny off the bus. Oh, you can shove your granny, cause she's your mammy's mammy. Oh, you can shove your granny off the bus. Off the bus.
There's a lot of people out in the street right now.
Okay, back to another slow song. This song, for this concert, we do songs and then we research kind of like the background of the song because I think it helps us all connect with the songs and what we're singing. This one is called Will You Go, Lassie Go. And when I started looking up it online, trying to look up the history of it, you find out it was named, Mountain Wild Thyme or Purple Rose, because, and all of those words are in, or Bloom and Heather, they're all in the song. And I can imagine at some point in folk songs, someone at some point decides to claim the song. So they take the song, they write it for the lyrics for their family, and then they say, this is our song, the McPeak family claims the song. Well, I found out that the McPeak family claimed this song, and this last verse was a verse added by their son when their father got remarried. And the verse is like, if my true love, she were gone, I would surely find another to pull wild thyme around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie, go? Anyway, so there's a little bit of background. Let's see how it goes. Oh, the summer time is coming, and the trees are sweetly blooming, and the wild mountain thyme grows around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie, go? And we'll all go together to pull wild mountain thyme all around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie, go? I will build my love a bar near yon pure crystal fountain, and around it I will place all the flowers of the mountain. Will you go, lassie, go? And we'll all go to pull wild mountain thyme all around the blooming heather. Will ye go, lassie, go? If my true love she were gone, I would surely find another to pull wild mountain thyme all around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie, go? And we'll all go together to pull wild mountain thyme all around the blooming heather. Will you go, lassie, go?
Thank you.
While we're waiting for Karen to get her stuff, these are a couple songs that Karen wrote, and they're in memory of her leader dog that passed. She has a new one named Maya, but before she had a dog named Minky.
Karen, I'm coming to you. Are you talking about this?
Sure. So, as Bob just said, I wrote these two pieces called Minky's Jig and Giggle Ball Jig. And Minky's Jig was actually written after Giggle Ball. But Giggle Ball was actually written while I was on a ski trip. And Giggle Ball is called Giggle Ball because she had a toy called the Giggle Ball, and it made weird noises. But Minky's Jig has three parts, an A part, a B part, and a C part. And the C part, well, it reminds us all of something Minky used to do when she would take walks. So we're not going to go into detail unless you want to know after the concert. So hope you enjoy it. Oh, and this is Maya, By My Feet.
It looked tough. Just put one more. Before we start, so I just want to let you know that Johnny Cash wrote this Irish song. Didn't know that Johnny Cash is Irish. Probably not. I close my eyes and picture the emerald of the sea, from the fishing boats at Dingle to the shores of Donaghadee. I miss the River Shannon and the folks at Skipperine, the moorlands and the meadows with their 40 shades of green. But most of all, I miss the girl from Tipperary town, and most of all, I miss her lips as soft as eiderdown. Again, I want to see and do the things we've done and seen, with the breeze as sweet as Shalimar and the 40 shades of green. I wish that I could spend an hour at Dublin's churning, sir. I'd love to watch the farmers drain the bogs and spade the turf, to see again the thatches of the straw the women glean. I'd walk from Corney to Larney to see the 40 shades of green. But most of all, I miss the girl from Tipperary town, and most of all, I miss her lips as soft as eiderdown. Again, I want to see and do the things we've done and seen, with the breeze as sweet as Shalimar, and there's 40 shades of green. Thank you.
So our next little bit is a little bit different. Instead of just, yes, or maybe both of us. You notice we're the only two weirdos in kilts here.
And we don't even have to put a mic on it, do we?
Very true. So while we're going contemporary, this is not a traditional Scottish dance, although it is a traditional Scottish tune. So the tune, you will know, it's Scotland the Brave. This is a dance that I wrote specifically for this tune. And there's kind of a long background about me wanting to write tunes that could be danced to typical pipe band tunes, so that way if any of us dancers ever show it to a band and they say, will you dance, we can already do something to a tune that they definitely know. Ian happens to be a great piper for dancers. I've danced with his sister before, and so I don't really need to do any tunes that he would not know because he knows them all, but we're going to give this a shot. So this is Scotland the Brave.
Thank you.
Well, Katharine, that was great. And Ian, nice playing too. That was great. Thank you so much. Well, I was telling you about how emotional these Irish songs can get, and this one is definitely one of those. This one's called Donald, Wear Your Trousers. Trousers or trousers. It's just, I don't know, apparently that's how it's pronounced there. Oh, that's right. We need you guys.
Do you have the words of this,
the words are on the back for the chorus. We're going to teach you the words. Is let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low, through the streets in my kilt all go. All the lassies say hello, Donald, wear your trousers. Okay.
Let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low, through the streets in my kilt I'll go. All the lassies say hello, Donald, where's your trousers?
I just come down from the Isle of Skye, I'm not very big, but I'm awfully shy. Lassies shout when I go by, Donald, where's your trousers?
Let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low, through the streets to my kilt I'll go. All the lassies say hello, Donald, where's your trousers?
A lassie took me to the ball, it was slippery in the hall. I was feared that I would fall, for I had nae on me trousers.
Let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low, through the streets to my kilt I'll go. All the lassies say hello, Donald, where's your trousers?
Now I went down to London town, and I had some fun on the underground. The ladies turned their heads around, saying,
Donald, where are your trousers?
Let the wind blow high,
let the wind blow low, through the streets in my kilt I'll go. All the lassies say hello, Donald, where's your trousers?
Well, I caught a cold and me nose was raw, I had a handkerchief at all. I put my kilt and I gave it a blow, then cannot do that with your trousers.
Let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low, through the streets in my kilt I'll go. All the lassies say hello, Donald, where's your trousers?
To wear a kilt is my delight. It's not wrong, I know it's right. The Highlanders would get a fright if they saw me in the trousers.
Let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low, through the streets in my kilt I'll go. All the lassies say hello, Donald, where's your trousers?
Lassies want me, everyone, then let them catch me if they can. You cannot take the breaks of a Highland man, I don't wear the trousers.
Let the wind blow high, let the wind blow low, through the streets in my kilt I'll go. All the lassies say hello, Donald, where's your trousers?
Okay, for this next one, I'm going to need to do a quick and dirty costume change, so Melissa and Dave and Karen are going to talk to you about accordions, which we'll feature in our next piece, and how they work and why they're cool, and I'll try to be fast.
Oh, that's a new one. let's see here. Can I use that music stand? Or do you need it?
Thanks for coming today, everybody. As most of you may know, this is to help support the music department fund that we use for hiring soloists and purchasing music. So there's offering plates at the back. Don't be afraid to make a contribution.
We're supposed to talk about how we work these things.
I didn't know
we
were
going.
Yes, we do. We'll just come over here.
Is she going to dance? Is she dancing to this one?
There you go.
This is a hop to California, right?
We're going off to California.
And she's going to be.
Oh, wait, aren't I supposed to move?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, here. Come and join us.
No, she needs to. Oh, she's going to come over here. Okay.
I'll leave.
Ian's over there.
Ian's over there. Kate, who's back there.
And Melissa's right there.
She kind of put the whole list of songs together for us, and she decided that we should do an accordion trio. I don't know whose great idea that was.
I don't know. That idea was brought on because I've since started learning how to play the accordion.
That's true. That's true. I guess you say Dave's accordion. That's Dave. And then Dave got a new accordion.
I'm still trying to learn how to play it, but one thing cool about this accordion, it was actually made in Detroit by Italian immigrants.
Wow.
So, but it was given to me by a late friend, needed a lot of repairs, and took over a year to get it back, so I'm still relearning it.
But it is a tricky song. We've got some jumps in here that are a little tricky.
Yes.
Yeah, so, just be, have a little grace.
Yeah.
And we're still waiting for Kate.
Just want to start it and we'll do it.
No, we shouldn't start it yet.
Okay.
We sound like something out of like Abbott and Costello. anybody got a question for us? Pardon?
How long have you been playing those?
Maybe like 6 months.
I played as a kid and I picked it up again. I'm still picking it up and haven't gotten much on this hand yet.
How about you, Melissa?
I actually started playing it when I was smaller, but I stopped playing it when I learned how to play the organ. So then I stopped playing
it. Oh, look at this.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, hang on.
Big circles?
Yeah.
This is cute. Okay, so you
got, you gotta get back here.
We didn't block this out before, as you can tell. Can she come up right on the side?
Oh,
we'll
let's see here. Can...
Yes.
All right, so let me move this up here. Oh. All right, Carrie, come on up here, then.
I'm gonna go back just one step right there. And the chair.
Where's the music here?
The music's...
All right, can you see, Dave?
I can't
Does
see it at all.
Does that give you enough space?
Yes.
I can see it now.
Can you see?
I can see it.
All right.
Okay,
oh,
so.
Wait, the kid's going to hit the piano.
Oh.
Just move the piano. There you go.
Let's just move the piano.
Oh, my God.
We did not prepare this part.
Okay, so something you need to know about this dance, besides the fact that obviously it's a sailor's hornpipe, and I had to change partly so you'd get the full hornpipe experience and partly because hornpipe's kind of awkward in a kilt, so that wasn't going to work. So I wrote this dance yesterday, put all the choreography steps together. So I hope I remember it all. And also, it's played well slower than we would normally play it, so this is going to take a lot more strength and control than we're usually having to show. So you're going to have to watch and see if I'm strong enough to work on board a ship or not. So I chose a variety of different steps, so I'm doing like half steps, so that way you can see a lot of the different steps for hornpipe, which shows a lot of the things that you would see a sailor doing on a ship. So you'll see me like hauling hope, a rope, reaching out my hand to get my pay and everything, so... Have fun.
All right, so we measure before you come in.
Okay.
All right, you guys ready?
Ready?
Thank you.
just go.
Where's this seat go?
Okay, Maya is in the way here, so we'll have to step over her.
Maya.
Okay, everyone, this next song is called Grace, and I have a little bit to say about it, just to give you kind of a sense of what's happening. This is a song written in 1985, so fairly recent, but it sounds like a folk song that you would hear in the Irish music. This is a story about Joseph Plunkett, who is singing this song to his beloved Grace Gifford. He's singing this song the day before he is executed. This is in 1916, and he is part of an Irish rebellion against the British rule of Ireland. And so there has been this uprising, and he obviously was captured, and now he is sentenced to death the following morning, but he wants to get married to his beloved Grace. Oh, one last thing. So Joseph Plunkett, the man who's going to be executed, was very faithful in his Christianity. And he wrote a poem, and you will hear some of the words in this poem. I'll point out the words. The poem starts with, "I see his blood upon the rose." And if I continue, it says, "And in the stars, the glory of his eyes, his body gleams amid eternal snows. His tears fall from the skies. I see his face in every flower. The thunder and the singing of the birds are but his voice. And carven by his power, rocks are his written words. All pathways by his feet are worn. His strong heart stirs the ever-beating sea. His crown of thorns is twined with every thorn. His cross is every tree." And you will hear his blood upon the rose in this song. Hope you enjoy it. As we gather in the chapel here, in old Kilmainham jail, I think about these past few weeks. Oh, will they say we failed? From our school days, they have told us we must yearn for liberty. Yet all I want in this dark place is to have you here with me. Oh, Grace, just hold me in your arms and let this moment linger. They take me out at dawn and I will die. With all my love, I place this wedding ring upon your finger. There won't be time to share our love, for we must say goodbye. Now I know it's hard for you, my love, to ever understand the love I bear for these brave men, my love for this dear land. But when Patrick called me to his side down in the GPO,
I had to leave my own sick bed. To him I had to go. Oh, grace, just hold me in your arms and let this moment linger. They'll take me out at dawn and I will die. With all my love, I place this wedding ring upon your finger. There won't be time to share our love, so we must say goodbye. Now as the dawn is breaking, my heart is breaking too. When they march me out on this gray morn, my thoughts will be of you. And I'll write some words upon the wall so everyone may know. I love so much that I could see his blood upon the rose. Oh, grace, just hold me in your arms and let this moment linger. They'll take me out at dawn and I must die. With all my love, I place this wedding ring upon your finger. There won't be time to share our love, so we must say goodbye. Oh, there won't be time to share our love, for we must say goodbye.
Nice job, Barry.
So this next tune set is called the Bird Set. This one's one of mine. The two tunes in it are called The Zebra Finches, named after some zebra finches that my mom and I had throughout our time of growing up. And then there's The Hens Next Door, which is clearly named after the hens who live next door to me. And I've played it for them, and they like it, so it must be a hit. So the first tune is called a slip jig or a hop jig. It's in 9/8, and then the second one is just a regular double jig, and that's in 6/8. So if it sounds like the time signature changes, yes, it does.
Thank you.
Nice tune, Katharine.
So this next one is also a tune you know because we've played it many times, Whiskey in the Jar, but this is the version that Thin Lizzy did. So a little more contemporary, a little more fun. I had to convince Bob to do this one. So today we've got the electric guitar, and it's more of a rock tune, and it's a lot of fun.
As I was going over the Cook and Carry Mountains, I saw Captain Fell and his money he was counting. I first produced my pistol and then produced my rapier, saying, "Stand and deliver, or the devil he may take ya." My shot.
Da-da-da. Whack for the daddy-o, whack for the daddy-o.
There's whiskey in the jar. I took all of his money, and it was a pretty penny. I took all of his money, and I brought it home to Molly. She swore that she loved me, never would she leave me. But the devil take that woman, for you know she tricked me easy.
You dumb and dumb. Whack for the daddy-o, whack for the daddy-o. Whack for the daddy-o, whack for the daddy-o.
Like the fishing, and some men like the fowling, and some men like to hear the cannonball a-roaring. Me, I like sleeping, especially in my Molly's chamber. But here I am in prison, here I am with ball and chain, yeah.
Whack for the daddy-o, whack for the daddy-o.
There's whiskey in the jar.
And now for something completely different.
This last piece is entitled Isle of Hope, Isle of Tears, and it's really about the Irish immigrants coming through Ellis Island and how in 1892 and how fearful, you know, some of these people may have been, especially Annie Moore, who was the first one to cross the threshold at 15 years old. They opened Ellis Island and they let the people through. And the first to cross the threshold of the Isle of Hope and Tears was Annie Moore from Ireland, who was all of 15 years. Isle of Hope, Isle of Tears, Isle of Freedom, Isle of Fears, but it's not the isle I've left behind. That Isle of Hunger, Isle of Pain, I will never see again, but the Isle of Home is always on your mind.
Disappears, 'cause there's no future in the past when you're 15 years.
Isle of Hope, Isle of Tears, Isle of Freedom, Isle of Fears, but it's not the isle I've left behind. That Isle of Hunger, Isle of Pain, I will never see again, but the Isle of Home is always on your mind.
When they closed down Ellis Island in 1943, 17 million people had come there for sanctuary. And in springtime when I came here and I stepped upon its piers, I thought of how it must have been when you're only 15 years.
Isle of Hope, Isle of Tears, Isle of Freedom, Isle of Fears, but it's not the isle I've left behind. That Isle of Hunger, Isle of Pain, I will never see again, but the Isle of Home is always on your mind. Isle of Hope, Isle of Tears, Isle of Freedom, Isle of Fears, but it's not the isle I've left behind. That Isle of Hunger, Isle of Pain, I will never see again, but the Isle of Home is always on your mind. Yes, the Isle of Home is always on your mind.
Thank you.
We got one more. I got one more of these little things.
What is it?
No. You're off the hook.
So this next one's another reel. It's called The Gravel Walks, and it's a lot of fun to play on the fiddle.
Oh, I got to find it. Hang on a minute. Give me a second. There it is. Yeah. Welcome to FCC, and there's some refreshments in the out in the narthex, so please help yourself to that, too. We're so thankful that you all came here today. Thank you for being part of this fun night. Have a fun afternoon.
Thanks for coming. Come back next year.
Look at that.
Good job, you guys.
He's just sitting there.
Last time, so I love it.